Hallelujah. Well, all right. How to increase your faith. That's what I'm talking about right now. How to increase your faith. Everyone wants to know how to increase their faith. You know, one of the gospel scriptures, a gentleman came to the Lord and said, help my unbelief. Jesus can't help your unbelief. No, he can't just wave his hand and you have faith. That doesn't happen. You know, Romans 10:17, faith comes by hearing, hearing by the word. But I'm talking now how to increase your faith, because you got the measure of faith. Romans 12:3, I'm giving you scripture verses. He says, we have been dealt the measure of faith. You got that when you heard the word of God and got born again. You have the measure of faith, and that's all the faith you needed for the rest of your life. Now it's the application of your faith. And if you want to increase what you're doing with your faith, in Luke chapter 5, that's what the apostles asked Jesus. They said, Lord, increase our faith. And he didn't give them this long dissertation or anything or any explanation. He just said, if you have faith the size of a grain of mustard seed, you will say to this sycamine tree, be removed, plucked up, and so forth. And the operative term here is you would say. And that's what we have to do with the word of God. We just say, Mark 11:23-24, you say to this mountain, be removed and tossed into the sea. Don't doubt in your heart, but believe the things you say come to pass. You have what you say. He said that you don't have to ascend to the highest of the heights. You don't have to go to the depths of the sea to find your answer or your blessing or your solution for anything. He said, the word is near you in your mouth and it's in your heart. That's your spirit. It's the word of faith which we preach. That's how it works. It's near you. This was written in Deuteronomy chapter 30 before the Apostle Paul put the tag, which is the word of faith. It was already there. You don't have to go high. You don't have to search low. He said, your answer is in your mouth and it's in your heart. What you believe, say it. So how do you increase your faith? I use an analogy before, a demonstration before, with balloons. The balloon is your heart, your spirit. And as I blow into the balloon expands. But what am I blowing? I'm blowing the word into my heart, because that's what my breath is to the balloon. So the more word I put in my heart, what do I believe with? My mouth? No, I believe with my heart. So if all there is in my heart, Luke 6:45, out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. So what's in my heart? If all I have in my heart is the word of God, what's going to rise up when the doctor says I'm sick? I'm going to say, no, by his stripes I'm healed. What's going to rise up when the devil tells me, or machinations tell me, I'm not going to make it till next month? The word's going to rise up and say, my God shall supply all my need. What's going to happen? Are you with me? When it seems like I'm addicted to something, can't get delivered from this or that, the word is going to rise up. Colossians 1:13. I have been delivered from the powers of darkness. Translated to what's going to rise up when fear comes upon me? It's Psalm 27. The Lord is my light, my salvation. Whom shall I fear? You see, as long as I keep saying the word, I fill the word up in my heart, and that's how my faith increases. Really, the word increases in me, and I have more ammunition to stand on. That's how you increase your faith. So you got to put in the work, man. You got to decree a thing. Speak the word of God to yourself. Get all the promises that you can concerning any area of your life and pray them out loud on a daily basis, because the tongue is a pen of a ready writer. You'll be writing the word in your heart. And when you open up your mouth, that's what's going to come out, not the old garbage that the world be trying to say. No, the word is going to come out. That's how you increase your faith. Praise God for you. Click subscribe right now to this BFABP on this YouTube vlog site. And then also go to my website, AnthonyBlackmanMinistries.com, and you can see my Facebook is BFABP. All my entire sermons are on there as well. I pray for my subscribers on a daily basis. I love you. I care for you. It's a wonderful life, and you have the best day of your life. In Jesus' name, hallelujah.